Okay, we have a last method of solving systems, which is a solution by the inverse matrix. Let's adjust the camera slightly. Okay, solution by the inverse matrix. An example, let's take this system here, okay? This system can be written, as we saw a couple of classes earlier, in the form A times an X vector equals a Y vector. Okay, now what I mean by that is if we write out the coefficient matrix 4, 7, 5, negative 3, multiplied by x, y, we get negative 5, 12. Meaning, of course, this row times this column, and this row times this column, as you know, is 4 times x plus 7 times y, is going to be equal to the corresponding number over here. First row times the column gives us the first number, and that's our first equation. Second row times the column gives us our second number, and that's the second equation. Now, the solution to this matrix equation, let me comment also, this x and this y are all big and fancy to distinguish them from this x and this y. This x refers to the column xy. Okay, so we don't want to be confusing big X with little x. They mean something different. The big X means the column xy, which is, if we can evaluate xy, we have our solution. And the big Y doesn't have anything to do with the little y. It's the column vector negative 5, 12 that comes from the right-hand side of the equation, the right-hand sides of the two equations. So, we have an equation of form AX equals Y. How would you ordinarily solve an equation AX equals Y? Well, I have a little bit of room over here. So I'm going to just write an equation, like I say, 5X equals 23. How would you solve that equation? Well, you would divide by 5. Now, A here represents the coefficient matrix, and we don't have a rule for dividing by a matrix. We have a rule for multiplying by a matrix, but you can go ahead and think of any rule you like for dividing by a matrix, and you can try it out, and it's just not going to work. There's no good rule for dividing by a matrix. However, to solve this equation, we could also multiply both sides by 5 to the negative 1. Now, I've got to be a little bit careful here. Matter of fact, I don't want to do that in this step. What I want to do is I want to say, okay, we can multiply this on both sides by 5 to the negative 1. So we have 5 to the negative 1 times 5x would then equal 5 to the negative 1 times 23. Now, I could have done what I started to do up here. I could have multiplied 23 times 5 to the negative 1. But when you're multiplying matrices, because we're going to make an analogy with matrices, it makes a big difference on which side you multiply the matrix. So if I multiplied by the matrix on this side, it would have given me a different result than multiplying by it on this side of the 23, or of the x. And we'll follow the analogy. So by analogy with this, I've just got a to the negative 1 times a, multiplied by, well, I just multiplied both sides of this equation by a to the negative 1. A to the negative 1 we call the inverse matrix. Okay? Now, you don't know how to get an inverse matrix, but you're going to in a minute. If we do that, well, just as here, 5 to the negative 1 times 5, that's a multiplicative inverse, and that's going to give us just x. And then 5 to the negative 1 times 23, well, the multiplicative inverse of 5 is 1 over 5, so that's going to give us 23 over 5. So, by analogy, when we multiply the inverse matrix by the matrix, it goes away. It actually gives us the identity matrix, but I'm not going to discuss the identity matrix. I'm just going to say this works, and if you do a little bit more with matrices, and probably next time we'll talk a little bit more about the identity matrix, but you just, by analogy, 5 to the negative 1 times 5 gives you the identity, which multiplied by x is just x. This times this gives you the identity, and when you multiply the identity by x, you just get x. On the right-hand side, you have a inverse times y. Now, why is this a column vector? If we had an inverse matrix, we'd be able to multiply it by that column vector and get a result. So, how do we get the inverse matrix? Well, I'm just going to tell you here, and then I'm going to extend the class notes by actually working it out. We didn't have time at the end of class to work it out, and this is something I promised for the next class, but we're going to go ahead and do it here in just a minute. So to find A inverse, we row reduce this matrix. Now, how do we get this matrix? Well, over here, we just have our coefficient matrix. Over here, we have that thing I called the identity matrix. For right now, you can just understand the identity matrix has ones on this diagonal here, which we call the main diagonal, and zeros on the other diagonal. Actually, zeros everywhere we don't have ones. And the only place we have ones is on the main diagonal. So if you had a 3x3 matrix, you'd put three ones down here on a diagonal and then fill in the rest of the matrix with zeros. Okay, well, anyhow, we get this matrix. This is an augmented matrix. We learned earlier how to reduce an augmented matrix. I'd start by multiplying this row by 1/4, which would give me a 1 here, and then I'd add negative 5 times that row, which now has a 1 here, to match up with this 5 and give me a 0 here. Then whatever number I have here, I'd divide the rest of the row by that. Wouldn't affect the 0, would give me everything, would give me some numbers over here, and I'd have a 1 here now. And then I'd take negative 7 times this and add it to this row, which will give me a 0 here. Now, when I do that, and you don't need to remember everything I said or understand everything I said, although if you've done a number of augmented matrices and row reduced them, you would understand pretty well what I said. And you understand that these numbers are going to change with all those operations. They're going to change into something. And what we end up with here is the identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1, and then whatever comes out of the process on this side. And whatever comes out on the process is our inverse matrix. Having found the inverse matrix by a fairly straightforward procedure, we multiply it by the negative 5/12, the y vector, and we get the x vector, which will be our solution.